Well, it is a topic that's very difficult to discuss, but teenage suicide is a tragedy that occurs in every community. It's the number three killer of teens across the United States every year, number two in Kent County. Second only to accidental deaths.
The statistics are almost hard to believe, but today we are talking about the difficult subject with two women who know firsthand the pain the silence has caused.
Christy Buck is with the Mental Health Foundation. Jenny Fritz, a mom who lost her 16-year-old son, Brandon, to suicide. And Christy, let's start with you because there's a big effort, especially this weekend, with a walk that's going on. I love the name of it, Out of the Darkness.
Yeah, it's an amazing walk. And what they're doing is it takes place every first weekend in October. And actually, it goes hand in hand with what is National Mental Illness Awareness Week, which is the first week in October. And the walk, the name Out of the Darkness, stemmed from a larger walk that happens in larger cities where people walk through the whole night.
Wow.
Darkness and then into the light. And it's actually a walk to help prevent suicide, but it is, many of the people that participate are survivors of suicide. And when we say that term, survivor of suicide, many people think it's people that attempted and survived. But no, it's actually a loved ones, friends, family that were left behind. They're the survivors of suicide.
That's right. And we have Jenny Fritz here. Your 16-year-old son, Brandon, introduced us to this amazing young man. He's the same age as my daughter.
Brandon was, he was an amazing kid. He was loved to be the center of attention. His favorite line every day was, "Do you know who I am?" Everybody had to know who Brandon was. And he was happy. He loved life more than anybody. And we woke up one day, or I woke up one day, because I worked third to the horrible tragedy that he had hung himself in our basement.
Wow. And here he is. He was an active kid.
Very active.
A wrestler, a three-sport athlete,
yes.
Really. It wasn't just wrestling. I mean, he was an active, energetic,
yes.
Smart kid, great student.
Yeah, he wrestled all year long. Five days a week he practiced. He wrestled on Saturdays. He took one day off, and we'd always try to slow him down just because of the pressures of kids. And you know, he always wanted to get that scholarship to go to U of M. That was his thing. And we're like, you know, we'll figure it out. But he just wouldn't stop.
Wow.
Well, you mentioned, you know, it's very difficult 5 days a week, you know, doing the sports. I think in general, it's just difficult being a teenager. You know, you have your emotions you're going through, you know, your puberty, probably your first serious relationship and so forth. That's a lot to handle for kids. And they're trying to discover themselves as well. Are there warning signs to this at all?
Yeah, on a lot of it, 9 out of 10 times, those who have taken their lives by suicide had either depression or substance abuse. But a lot of times they don't want to talk about it. And that goes with, you know, what I'm wearing, my T-shirt, stigma, that I can't be crazy nuts and psycho. And if I'm having feelings like this, and for boys especially, I can't feel really sad about a girlfriend breaking up with me. And you know what? That is sad. And we need to allow kids to express their feelings and express their emotions. And we can't just talk to kids to say, you know, shake it off. I mean, the shake it off is done. We need to start really taking it serious. And so looking for sadness, little interest in doing things, down, depressed, hopeless, trouble falling asleep, trouble staying awake, feeling bad.
Changes in
weight,
that sort of thing.
Huge. And they are relating directly obesity with depression now. Okay, so I read an article the other day. And then, of course, talk about not wanting to be around anymore. You don't, you know, nobody would miss me if I weren't here. Those are actual talk of suicide.
Okay, Christy, you are in schools every day talking to kids. You have a great program that you have started because, I mean, I don't think it's an overstatement to say it is an epidemic.
It is.
It's a health crisis for our kids.
It is. Thank you for recognizing that because it is. It is the number two leading cause of death amongst high school students in Kent County. We have to talk about it and we have to educate. And it is a myth that if we talk about it, people are going to go out and kill themselves. That is not true. The truth is, as it goes back to depression, people feeling the pressures, environmental changes in kids' lives and adults. And so we have to be diligent about this. There's a high percentage of suicides also by people that are 65 and older in Kent County.
We don't talk about that either.
Not at all. And a lot of it is you need to start to slow down. And is that natural? Do people need to really slow down? Or is slowing down in the later stages of life because they're depressed? Mm. Nobody wants me around. And so we really need to be watching this. This is information not only just for kids. It is for adults, and it is for, you know, middle-aged. I mean, it is a crisis in our community.
College kids, too. Tell us about the Live, Laugh, Laugh, Love program.
Well, the Live, Laugh, Love program is a program we created. It's a curriculum that goes into schools, and there's an a la carte menu, or you can get 8 weeks of mental health. And a lot of it is just, you know, demystifying the mystery of what is mental illness. And basically, if we have physical illness, we have mental illness. And we're teaching kids, and when they hear the word mental, that it really means about your mind, it doesn't mean mental, that it's okay to go ask for help. And so it's called Live, Laugh, Love, and it's so much fun, and we absolutely love it. And people like Jenny have taken me to the point where I know that it's needed in every school. And Jenny is an amazing woman who has the courage to come out and tell her story, because the stigma that goes to families who have lost their loved ones by suicide is horrific. You don't know what to say at the time of death, and you know what, they lost a battle, and that's what we need to look at it as.
So Jenny, why are you public about this? I mean, I really commend you. I can't imagine as a mom.
I think the worst thing is what Brandon must have felt like in that moment. And I just don't want anybody else to think they have to feel like that. There's always somebody to talk to. If you can't talk to your parents, talk to a teacher, to a friend, to a stranger. I mean, anybody. You don't have to feel like that. You're not alone.
Now, Christy was talking about some of the possible warning signs, and I was just wondering, did you happen to see anything glaring?
You know, looking back, at the time I didn't see anything. It was just a broken heart. You know, he had had a big wrestling tournament, and he didn't place where he'd wanted to, so he was upset. And I had actually, that morning when I took him to school, I said, we're going to talk tonight, because he was leaving 3 days later to go to Ohio to wrestle, and I said, we're going to talk tonight, because I knew something was bothering him. But I just thought, it was teenage things. I didn't know about suicide, so I didn't know to talk to him until it was too late.
Well, and you know what, that's why this is so important, because there's not a manual of how to raise a good teen.
No.
And so you're there with the kids in the trenches.
You got it.
And that's why we need to talk about this.
Yeah.
So let's remind people about the event on Saturday. It's a walk. It's a time to come together. It's a time to share. It's a time to educate. It's a time to shine the light.
It's very powerful.
Yep, it is powerful.
And here it is. We invite everybody to attend Millennium Park. A beautiful venue. Saturday morning, registration at 9 o'clock. The walk begins at 10. Thank you both so much for sharing.
Thank you. And thank you for having us.
Absolutely. We need to talk about it.
Keep talking about it.
Silence is deadly when it comes to suicide.
Sure is.
Thank you. We'll be right back.